Place doesn't seem any different. Oh, what's this? Birgit was made flower maiden at the 47th Sacred Flower Festival. It looks like the Sacred Flower Festival is over.
I wonder what Olivia is doing. Let us go visit the matriarch.
You be, child.
I am the vessel of wind, Agnès Oblige.
Ah, oh, I see it now. My, but you've grown, dear. Florum is more beautiful for your visit. If only Olivia were alive to see you, she would have been so happy.
What? You mean Olivia is...
About 6 months ago, I am afraid. There was a great earthquake at the Hidden Village, and she perished protecting her crystalists.
It cannot be.
Her successor was rejected by the Orthodoxy due to her illness, and there is no other. She was such a talented child, but the Orthodoxy cast her out.
And what of the water crystal?
The shield put in place by Olivia disappeared with her demise. Now I fear that not a soul can get near it.
Then we must act. Leave this to me.
Of course. I pray you are able to bring the light back to the water crystal, Wind Vestal.
Thank you. Bye. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Tyria!
You. So it is you, Adia. You are the last person I expected to run into here.
There's nobody here. This is the hidden village of the Crystalists. Why would it be empty? No. Could this be the work of the Duchy?
This place has been deserted for ages. Since well before I was sent to these lands.
What?
This is indeed the hidden village of the Crystalists. I have explored it a number of times, but I never found any trace of people living here.
Now that you mention it, it doesn't look like anyone has lived here for years.
Perhaps they orchestrated their own destruction.
What do you mean?
The Orthodoxy was consumed by greed and obsessed with power. They paid no heed to the people's needs. I would not be surprised if the Orthodoxy's corruption spread here, causing it to collapse from within.
I served only the crystal and knew nothing of the world until I left the temple. So I cannot know if what you say about the Orthodoxy's corruption is true. However, I know for a fact that you oppress not the Orthodoxy, but innocent Crystalists. Regardless of your lofty ideals, this cannot be forgiven.
Yes, you are right. We capture followers and force them to convert, to erode the Orthodoxy's power. We use violence to wrest them away from their beliefs. This is our goal, by fair means or foul. However, I must admit, I have grown slightly weary of the Legion's tactics.
Weary?
My sisters, Mephilia and Artemia. They have been scarred by the things they were ordered to do. You turned your back on the Duchy, Adia. I could not excuse your conduct. But I understood your reasons. Somehow. In a way, I envied your ability to take meaningful action.
Then it is not too late for you. Leave the Bloodrose Legion and come with us. It would be a boon to have you on our side, Angeria.
That I cannot do. I cannot.
But why?
You and I learned the ways of the sword under the same master. We have been through much. We swore our blades to the service of Eternia, and pledged to fight for her future. We swore we would honor the ideals held by the Grand Marshal, and strive to bring the world he envisioned to fruition.
But the reality we face is quite different from that my father sought. Surely you must see this.
Yes. The Bloodrose Legion and the Duchy have compromised those ideals. I know this as well as you.
Then why?
No ideals can be achieved by following the path of virtue alone. I will not look back, nor buckle at the knee, no matter how dirty my hands or sorrowful my heart. I must bring his world into being. We shall build a land where all are free from the crystal curse. I must continue this thankless task. I will fight on to the end. Let us make a clean fight of it. Me and my beliefs against you and yours.
myself is boundless!
You've grown stronger.
I'm Hyria.
Why do you weep? You've bested me. Be proud.
I never wanted.
Adia, hear me now. My final request. Meet with him. With your father. Face to face. No more intermediaries. Look at him. Look at him. And you'll see it. What he seeks. I know.
I will. I swear it to you.
Good. That's good.
Oh!
What?
Who are you? Mephilia!
Idea?
It's Idea! Filthy thing! Toying with my sister's heart! I've never seen so dirty a hypocrite. My sister loved you. Oh, but I'm not blaming you. This is far better than the way you used to be. It's so hideous, so deliciously twisted. I feel nauseous just speaking to you.
So you're killing fairies again? These fairies are incredibly important to Florim's people. How can you do this?
You've always been this way. Full of platitudes, happy lies. Always so pretty. So pretty you reek of rot and decay. Keep away, Idia. All humankind is dirty. A fine pack of filthy pigs. That girl with you, Idia. That is the Wind Vestal, is it not? Just how long do the two of you intend to feign trust? How long till the facades drop? What will it look like, I wonder? The moment all the little platitudes that hold you locked together start to crumble. Show me! Quickly! Quickly! Let me see your end.
Thank you.
you hail from. I know. You are not of this world. Where are you? Where?
She seemed to know what had happened to us.
It cannot have been pure conjecture. If only we could have questioned her further.
The ranger here.
Halt!
Artemia. So you still hunt the woodland Orochi here?
Artemia hunts many Orochi.
That I'm Hyria's orders?
Artemia, obey. Only obey. Sister's orders, only truth.
I see. You haven't changed. You could not stop Aenheria.
How Artemia live, not yours to say. How sister think, not yours to say. Artemia not tell sister how to think. How sister think, tell how Artemia live. Only sister tell how Artemia live.
I understand. I've heard enough.
Artemia, hunt.
hunt all prey. All in range. Artemia's prey.
I said enough.
Nothing runs. Nothing escapes. As long as prey has pulse, keep firing. Never miss! Never!
The things I do for you.
The word. With luck, this lunacy will cease soon.
Thank you.
Women are being tricked and captured in this world as well.
We must set them all free.
Ah, but that would put me in quite the bind.
It's the Red Old Man!
Now that is unfortunate. You could have at least called me dashing, don't you think? You do realize you are trespassing. I think it's time you ran along.
We know what you are up to. You must stop using these women for your wicked ends.
Oh, do you now, my pretty little thing? Well then, go ahead and tell me what I am doing.
Theramore toxin.
What? Well, knock me over with a feather. Just where did you hear that?
You told us yourself.
I did? Just a second. Have I met you somewhere before?
No, I believe you have yet to make our acquaintance.
Feigning ignorance, are we? Very well. How much do you know?
You use cologne containing pheromore toxin to trick and exploit women for your own gain.
Well, well. Isn't this awkward? You seem to have seen right through me. You do realize the women I woo get something out of this too, right? My techniques are truly superior. They all leave satisfied.
You filthy old man!
Oh, I thought I recognized you from somewhere. You're the Grand Marshal's daughter. You seem intent on disparaging my little operation. But I'll have you know the Council of Six has given full approval.
What?
Don't you see? Your father has personally condoned this operation that you call filthy. I fail to see how it warrants criticism from his own blood. Have I made myself clear? Good. Now off you go, children. I have much work to do here.
We're not going anywhere.
We'll not turn a blind eye to this wickedness.
Oh. So that is how you want to play it. I'll warn you,
I'm not the kind to roll over easily myself. It looks like I'll have to teach you the hard way. Since you're clearly incapable of managing my nickname, let's make this formal.
Yeah, we know. Captain of the Bloodrose Legion, the Red Mage, Old Man De Rosa!
Whoa, hold on there.
Thank you.
my glove!
What is it?
Oh, it's just...
Does it bother you that your father approved of that man's plan?
Yes.
Not to sound like Lord DeRosso, but don't you think you are underestimating him? When we obtained the report he had written earlier, I took down the details in my journal. the Red Mage has stopped at nothing to claw his way up the ranks of the Eternian forces. You should read them again sometime.
I will.